Welcome back to Project 365. We are almost at the end of July, sales month. And question for today is, what do I do if my customer won't pay? So first and foremost, this is why it's important to have a contract and have everything documented along the way. So we've talked about contracts at the beginning of this month, and we might have talked about documenting, but whenever you're working with the with your customers or clients, make sure that you have everything documented in terms of the contract, what you're delivering, deliverables are, communications, that includes text messages, phone calls, all that type of stuff, because that can all come back to bite you or help you along the way. So first, before you even get to the point of somebody not paying you, make sure that you're documenting everything so that if somebody decides that they're going to short you or contest a payment or something like that, you have plenty of information to, plenty of ammunition to support your case. So start off with reaching out. You don't want to, there could be some sort of misunderstanding. You don't want to be a complete jerk, especially if they're having some sort of personal issues or whatever. You know, try and solve everything that you possibly can between the two of you first. So that's reaching out to them, setting up a payment plan, giving them different options, whatever it is for payment. There's too many different scenarios to even really describe anything with, you know, on a video such as this. So get creative and just figure out different ways that would be helpful for them and that you can continue to get money. Because ultimately, you just want the headache to go away just like they do. So if you can get them to the point where they're paying you X number a month, whatever it is, that's fine. Once it gets to the point that maybe they're dodging phone calls or they're missing dates that they said they would pay you, whatever it is, again, documenting everything. So this is emails and communications. The more written communications you can send, the better. So you want to escalate the tone, get a little less friendly, get a little more matter of fact, whatever it is. This is where you want to kind of maybe talk to a lawyer. You're not going to get them involved yet, but just let them know this is something that they need to do. You can maybe consult them in terms of finding out what it is that you have available to you. The next step would be to actually get the lawyer involved. So now this is costing you money to get the payment. So you need to figure out whether or not it makes sense financially. And that's, I guess, for larger purchases. If it's a smaller purchase, if it's something, whatever it is, if they didn't pay you up front, that's kind of strange. But you can send them to collections. And so there's collection companies all over, and the how they charge and what the money that you get varies. But you can start by sending them to collections. You're going to have to provide that documentation that you tried everything that you possibly could. You can't just send anybody to collections. So they're going to need that contract. They're going to need the communications and all of that. If that doesn't work, you can always take them to court. But again, as you are going through this, it costs you time, it costs you money, it costs to try and collect on this. And at some point, it might just be worth calling it quits. So factor in everything that goes into the cost of collecting on that money. And if it's not worth it, and you just want to be spiteful, send them to collections, write it off, and just call it a day.